In this video, you will learn how the loft operation works in FreeCAD. This operation involves extruding through different sections, and that is, first we create sketches of cross sections at different heights, and then we create a 3D solid based on these cross sections. And in this video, I will also show you two ways to create sketches at different heights. Create a new project in Part Design Workbench. And select create sketch, select XY plane, and select create circle, and create a circle with a diameter of 50 millimeters. Okay, click close to exit the sketch. And now to create a sketch at different height, one way is to use the reference plane, and to create a reference plane in relation to the plane of the first sketch, select this sketch and select create a datum plane. And to make this plane at a different height, you need to move this plane in the z-axis, and to do this, enter 50 millimeters here. Okay. And now this plane is 50 millimeters above the plane of the first sketch. And to create a sketch on this plane, select this plane and select create sketch. Select this option and create an ellipse. Okay, and add dimensions. Select constrain horizontal distance, select this line and enter here 60 millimeters. Now select constrain vertical distance, select this line and enter 35 millimeters. Okay. Right click to cancel this command, and as you can see, the sketch is not fully constrained yet, and if you grab, for example, this point, you can move the geometry, and now select this point, select x-axis and select constrain point onto object, and click close to exit the sketch, and now we have two sketches at different heights. And based on this, we can now perform the loft operation, but we will add one more sketch. Let's create another reference plane. Select a second sketch to create another plane relative to this sketch. And select create a datum plane. And just like with the first reference plane, enter 50 millimeters here to make the next reference plane 50 millimeters above the previous reference plane. Okay. Select this plane and select create sketch and draw a circle with a diameter of 30 millimeters. Okay, click close to exit the sketch. You can turn off the visibility of reference planes, select the reference plane in the feature tree and press spacebar. Okay. And now to add the loft operation, select the first sketch and select Additive Loft. The first sketch will be the initial profile, and now click the Add Section button and select another profile and click Add Section again and select another profile. Click OK to accept. And in this way, we created a solid by extruding through sections. We can also do it a little differently. Let's undo this operation and let's turn on the visibility of sketches. Select it and press the spacebar. Okay. And now we can just select the three sketches with the control key pressed. The order of selection is important because this is the order in which the extrusion through the profiles will be made. Then select Additive Loft and click OK. And OK, this is how the Additive Loft operation works. You can add many more sections here to get a more complex design. But at the beginning I mentioned that there are at least two ways to create sketches at different heights. The first is the use of reference planes. And the second one is just moving the sketch. Let's create a new project and select create sketch, select the XY plane and draw a circle. OK, click close to exit the sketch, then create another sketch, also select the XY plane and draw a rounded rectangle. We will skip dimensioning and click close to exit the sketch. And now we have two sketches on one level, and to move a sketch, select the sketch in the feature tree, expand the attachment position and change the Z axis value. For example, 50 millimeters. Okay. And based on these sketches, you can perform the loft operation. Select the first sketch, select additive loft, click add section button and select next profile and click OK to confirm. Creating sketches at different heights and the loft operation are further possibilities for creating more complex designs. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel.